Okay, let's begin. We'll go through the basics to start with, and then we're going to go for it. So feet hips apart. Okay, you can find that by bringing them together. Toes turn out at 10 to 2, and then bring the heels the same distance apart as the toes. And then we're going to rock forwards and backwards. Okay, so just feeling the floor under your feet, the foundations, the stability, the sensory. So just push your toes down to the floor and back into your heels until you feel the weight evenly under both feet. So those 3 points. And then do it upside to side. Okay, and then find the middle. Okay, from there, pelvic tilt, go forwards and backwards. So we're getting that flexion and extension into the lumbar spine. So squeeze your bum and then push it out backwards. So just feeling that movement down here. You've just got to be careful when you do the extension if you've got any discompression, because you'll get pain. And then find halfway so the tailbone is pulling out. Now let's roll the shoulders. It's weird being back in it, really, 6 months. Well, I wouldn't say it does like yesterday anymore. I've done 550 something classes in that time. Aww. If not, it might be more than that.
Debbie's done probably
nearly as many. Debbie's done them all. She has as well. The screen looks like it's gone dark. Surprised the joints can still move. And relax the shoulders down. Okay, let's take a deep breath in. Reach up. And exhale. And again, reach, stretch up high. And reach up, let your shoulders shrug. And one more. And take it down. Okay, right arm over. And back. This might be the other way around on the screen because I've not done the mirror thing. So reaching over the top. Side bend, so again that lateral flexion. Let's increase the load with both arms. So just a little lateral flexion or forwards flexion if you've got any back issues. If you feel any pain, make it smaller. So in this class, we're just going for it, won't we? Keep the arms up, you've got giant ball, and go from side to side. Getting into those obliques, QLs of the lower back. It's mainly about mobilizing the spine, getting that fluid in between the vertebrae and your discs. Okay. One more each way. Last one. And then take it down. Hip hinge. Lengthen the spine. Okay, so you want to feel a stretch in your hamstrings when you're hip hinging, and then squeeze your glutes and hamstrings to bring back to the top. Flat back hip hinge. As if you had a pole on your back that's touching the back of your head, middle of your spine, and the sacrum. And squeeze your glutes to come back. So arms by the side for our first level. You can bring them up by the side of your hips like this. Level two. Going hands across the chest. Or level three, temples. It's quite challenging, you've got the hands there. So again, just watch that you don't end up flexing or looking towards your feet. You're looking forwards towards the floor in front of your mat. The work's coming from the back of your legs and your glutes. And your back extensor muscles. So really elongating the spine. One more. And back to center. And then relax the arms down to the side. Okay, take a step forwards, right foot. Okay, or whichever leg's going forwards and back. So do your heel strike. So when you step forwards, the leg will be pushed with, so you can walk forwards, tense up the glutes at the back. Stride. Push with the big toe, and you'll feel your glute glutes tense up, your hamstrings and your quads. Add an arm float. So you really feel those foot tips. Remember, beaches, not marshmallows. You don't forgot that, have you?
No. Beach,
I've got a lockdown marshmallow. Bow and arrow to the right. And then step back. So we're still in mobility phase. Good, so think about the rotation of your spine. So you twist it through the spine. Oops. Good. Lift up through the crown of the head. And if you can, look over your shoulder towards the back corner. Take a breath in, bend the arms up, you know what's coming, exhale, flat back, hip hinge. If you're okay to flex your spine, do that, and walk forwards into your high plank position. Okay, take your body weight forwards over your arms, let's just settle here for a second. Okay, give your bum a little bit of a squeeze. If you struggle with that on your toes, put your knees down. Now send your hips up in the air, tuck your chin in and look at your knees, and just try and tilt your tailbone up to the ceiling. So when we did the standing pelvic tilts earlier, we did a tuck under with the tailbone, and then we stuck the tailbone out backwards, and that's where you want to be, trying to do, stick your tailbone up to the ceiling. Okay, walk it back in, two, three, four, bend your knees and come up either the roll up or the squat. Circle the arms. Good. Take the feet a bit wider. Plie squats. Inhale down. Exhale lift. Just have a look at your knees. They're going towards the second and third toe. And if you can, that's so you can stand sideways on your mat if you slip at all. You've got socks on, be careful. Unless you can do the splits. I couldn't before, but I can now. Let's try and keep your pelvis in neutral if you can. I know it's quite hard to keep your back straight and do clean squats. If you can, we're here. If that's too much on your hips, then push your knee back in. Yay! Okay, hold it down. Stay here. Any problems with blood pressure, you're probably best keeping moving down and up, down and up. Because holding it down does start to raise your blood pressure. Little pulses. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it down. We okay? Keep your arms up, Sally. And Alex. And Meg. And Catherine. Arms up. Raise your right heel. 10 pulses. 10, 9, 8, 7. You missed me. 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it down. Place that heel down. Raise the heel up. 10 pulses. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Keep your head in the centre. 2, 1. Put both heels down. Curl your toes up. 10 pulses. 10, 9, 8, this is it. I promise. 7, 6, 5, 4. You feeling it?
Yes.
2, hold. Slowly up to the top. But now we just need to do some singles so we don't get dizzy. Just a few. Yeah, if we just hold to the top and stop, then that can make us get a little bit lightheaded sometimes. So a few more. Just a few more. And then last one. You can jump to the top here. Hit the back of your mat. Let's go for some Pilates mountain climbers. So you're in the center of your mat. Inhale. Reach up. Exhale. Hinge from the hip. You can flex if you're okay to flex, or bend your knees and squat. Walk forwards. Chest over the hands. Okay, so in that plank position. Yep. Yep. Okay, just throw your shoulder blades down. Okay, let's do 10 knees to chest if you can. 1. Keeping your body really still. 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. And 10. Bottoms up. Look up towards your knees. Tilt your tailbone up to the ceiling so you feel your back lengthen. You can probably feel a stretch down the back of your legs as well. And then walk your hands back in. Bend the knees. Come up either squat or roll up. Circle the arms. Take a step back with one leg, or a step forward with one leg. In our split position. Okay, have a look through your pelvis is level. We're not standing with the hips, but come to one side like that. Hands across the chest. Inhale, split squat. Use the front leg to lift. Inhale, exhale. Okay, as we come up, we're going to lift the back leg. We're going to come up, lift. Place it down. Squat, lift. So you're getting that hip extension and the glutes working. Do 5 more. 1. 2. Not squeeze your shoulder blades, just tiny little bit. Put your shoulders down. Now hold that leg up behind you and balance. Leg you're standing on, just relax the knee. Pulse that leg. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Feet side by side. Inhale, reach up. Hinge. Go forwards on your mat. And take your body weight over the arms. Squeeze your bum there. Slide your shoulder blades down away from the ears and lengthen your neck. Okay, take a breath in and exhale, we're gonna rotate knee to opposite wrist. 1, 2. Try and keep your body really still at the top. 3, rotate from the waist. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Walk back in. Bend your knees. Just have to keep your feet, get them in, back in alignment and roll up. Or hip hinges down. Reach. And then take your leg behind. Okay. We all okay? Yeah. Let's do the other side. Doing well. Hands across the chest. So I think we did 4 before we started lifting the leg up, and then we did number 10 with the leg lift. Okay. Pelvis in neutral, spine neutral. Inhale down. Exhale down. So just get used to doing the split squat using your front leg to push. Try and take a little bit of weight out of that leg. Start to raise that back leg. So 1, squeeze. 2, sitting right back. 3, a little bit more core engagement. 8, 9, and the last one. We hold it at the top and balance. Ooh, nearly. Hold and pulse for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well done. A little wiggle. Oh, let's do another plank. Fan the arms. Third plane movement. Taps out to the side. Hinge. Flex and walk forwards. Okay, so once you've got yourself set up in that plank position, slide your shoulder blades back. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, tap out to the side. Inhale, back. 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Bottoms up this time. Once we've got into that position, with your tailbone pointing up to the ceiling, have a look at your feet, check that the hip distance apart, and start to do foot pedals. So let's stretch your calves. This is where your socks start to fall off. One down and the other. So grab your calves. Good round the heel. Under the arch of the foot. Then push both heels down and walk your hands in. Bend the knees. And coming up. The shoulders are all. Excellent. You warm?
Yes.
Yeah, good. Whew, that was good.
Yes.
In fact, I'll tell you what. Welcome that one. A bit noisy about that. come down to kneeling. Take hold of your band. Is that the band? See the little Pilates kits. Have those bags lasted all night?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's all.
You used it.
Okay, so kneeling up, and we're going to take your leg out to the side. Okay, so if you struggle with your leg, you can put a block under your knee if you've got one. If you need to turn your foot out to the side, as long as you've got your pelvis facing this way so that your spine bends this way. It's not going backwards like that or forwards. Bring the arms up. You can do this with your arms up, or if it gets a little bit too much, you can do it with the hands across the chest. So let's go small, side bend, breathe out. Inhale, back in. So the band's just taut, tight, taut. That's a cake, isn't it? Taut. Okay, three, look at this. Pull the bottom hand down to the mat. So you still want to pull your shoulder blades down away from the ears. Five. Good. Six. Right. Just think about imagining sliding between two panes of the glass side to side. Seven. You can always make the band shorter if you want to work harder. Eight. Can you feel your obliques working on your side, yeah? Start doing the pull down, so we got to three. So I think we'll do three more. So then they said no good 10 pull downs. Two. If you've had enough, stop. If you want to keep going, we're going to hold it over without touching the floor. Push the arms a bit further out to the wall and hold the 10, 9, 8, 7. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and come up. And relax. Into shell stretch. That's one of my favourites. So that's your obliques and your QLs. You might not want to do the pull down. Three, okay, you ready? So we'll start from one again with the 10. Pull down. You can tap your finger on the floor, just don't rest. Two. So you stretch your one arm up and one down. Trying to get your band up to the vertical. Side bend, lateral flexion. Five. Good, that looks amazing, that. 6, all in formation. 7. With that touching the floor, 10, stay there. But now, shorten the band and bring it over here. Hold 10, 9, just open that top arm up, 8, so your head's slightly pitching the frame, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, can you feel it? 2, can you? 1, and up, well done. Boom, shell stretch. Give your bum a little wiggle with the shell stretch. Rock side to side. Come on. The heart beating faster. And then walk the hands back in. Okay, so whilst we're kneeling, take the band across the palms. We can do a waiter. We can do it without. You can kneel up or kneel down, whichever you want to do. Kneeling up, so it's a little bit harder because you have to work your glutes more. I can give you the lean back option as well. So pelvic tilt, tuck your tailbone down to the floor. Elbows against the ribs. Take a breath in. Exhale, stretch the band out to the side. Inhale back in. And 2, 3. So if you're okay with your knees, shoulders, the rotator muscles, opens up through the chest. Now let's do the opposite muscle to those by doing press-ups, or you can do band round the back, chest presses. So let's go to our hands and knees. You love these? First of all, get our perfect box position. So your knees are under your hips, your hands are under your shoulders. You can, if you want to, take your hands a little bit further forwards if you find it hurts your wrists. And if you can wiggle your fingertips, that usually takes quite a bit of a weight. If you have your hand back here like this, it just bends it back quite a lot, so you can have it further forwards. So we're going to take a breath in to come down when you're ready. And exhale, push away. So you do want to wait for your head to be in front of your fingertips. If you want to work harder, you can take the knees further back. So you're doing a 3/4, you're taking more body weight down towards the floor. Or you can go up onto your toes. You can take your hands closer together if you want to get your target your triceps more. If you want to work really hard, you can do that with the band and do press-ups. So if you really tighten it up like that, then the band's also pulling you down towards the floor and you have to push against it. How many have you done?
Yes.
We're stopping? Did I say stop? Come on, 10 more. How many have you done, Sam? She's done that around your neck. Your neck goes under your arms. That's why it's going around your neck. I can't stop you with that, of course. Last one. And relax. Well done. Okay, swing the leg around to front. Yes, yeah, it makes it more challenging, doesn't it? I've got plenty to bring down here on the other, haven't I? No, you stay there. You just stay right there. Okay, wiggle to the bottom of your mat, and if you can, bring your feet together on the centre line. So I'm glad you've got a line through the middle of your mat, and we'll do our roll backs. Chest up, shoulders back and down, look into the horizon, take a breath in to prepare. As you exhale, pelvic tilt and look down towards your thighs. Hold it, inhale, and exhale to flex forwards. Keep the flexion through your spine, keep looking to the floor, and when you get your chest to your thighs, inhale and look forwards into the horizon again. Arms in front. Chin tucked in. Breath in. Exhale. Flex and stretch through your core. Reach your little toes. And then lift. And if you want to, you can go up with your arms. So we breathe out as we move. Go a bit further if you can. Inhale. Exhale, engage your pelvic floor muscles, and forwards, and lift up to the top. You get the shoulder blades to tap the floor. Inhale, exhale, tuck the chin in, look towards your feet. So you want to keep flexing as far as you can, and then look straight forwards and up. Okay, you can go all the way down. When your knees are bent, your spine can flex a little bit better than it can when the legs are straight. So you've got that option of keeping them bent. Flex, flex, flex. It also protects your back a bit more when you're in this position at the top. Those of you who want to work harder, straighten your legs, point your toes, and then you roll it back as you exhale. Inhale, reach over. Exhale, come up. Tuck your chin in, tuck your chin in, tuck your chin in. So you're looking at your thighs. And then you restack up to the top. Okay, keep going. If you struggle to have your feet together, then you can go a little bit wider. But if possible, get them together in the middle. Give them a squeeze. Point your toes. Make it look pretty and graceful as possible. Should we have that one? Should we have that one? Just do a little tiny things back. Okay, just one more anyway, and then you can have a lie down. Hurrah! Keep going. And when you finish at the top, give the knees up against the chest. Okay. Sheila said she's definitely not using weights. So we have been doing quite a lot of weights with Pilates, so you might get a message telling you to bring some cans of beans or some weights with you. Okay, so let's do single leg stretch. So I'll just show you the routine we're going to go through. You'll all know this. We're going to do 20 single leg stretches. So you inhale through your nose as you pull the leg. Exhale. Okay, the abdomen's contracted. We're going to have a rest. You can always get with your head down. Then we're going to go into our double leg stretch. 10. Okay, now we're going to rest. Then we're going to do scissors. Same breathing pattern as the single leg stretch. You want those legs to be like shears. And then 100. And then we can have a rest. Deal?
Yay.
Deal? You can do that. We're going to have a little rest in between each one. When you're ready. I don't like that. Okay, so if you've got a neck issue, pop something under your head. Convenient if you've not got a block, just use your coat or your jumper. Alright, so let's. You want to be lay on the centre line of your mat. I'm going to be saying quite a bit, but centre lines. Take a breath in and exhale, gently contract. Bring your right knee up into your chest. Take the hands to the side of the knee, and if you can, curl up. Your other leg goes along the floor, like it's on a raised rail, about 4 or 5 inches. Look through your thighs towards your feet, and as you switch, they almost brush past each other. Okay, ready? Inhale, pull, exhale, switch. One, one, two, two, three, four. Four, so stay on that centre line. Five, your chin's tucked in, look through your thighs. Six, seven, seven, and really stretch. Eight, eight, push your toes this way. Nine, ten, ten, hug your knees in, let your head relax down, and roll it side to side. On the double leg stretch, you can keep your head on the floor if you need to. Okay, slide your hands down your shins. So with this one, as we curl up, we extend the legs away and the arms reach the ceiling. Breath in, prepare. Exhale, extend and come up. And inhale, sweep your arms round as your head comes down. Okay, feet together. Feet together, knees together. So we're going to go from now, 10 more. So exhale away. And two, and back. Tuck your chin in, then really look through your thighs, then look up to your knees to quit. Good, keep that going. Five, feet together, six, lower back's pushed into the mat, seven, eight, 9, and 1 more, 10, give your knees a hug again, and relax, let your head roll side to side. So the scissors are the same breathing pattern as the single leg stretch, so as you hold, got hold of the leg, inhale, you exhale, you're letting go and pushing it away. We're trying to keep the leg as straight as possible, so one's just off the floor and they switch like she is. If you can't do that full leg movement, you keep it small here like this. Okay, instead of going like this. Are we ready? So one leg up, climb up it. Other one goes forwards, a few inches off the floor. Tuck your chin in. Okay, ready? Pull as you inhale and exhale, release. One. Two, two, three, tuck your chin in, three, you brush past each other again, four, those ankles, four, try and get your knee to hit your head, five, six, go on, lengthen, eight, nine, 10, well done, hug your knees in, put the head roll side to side, and then, in a few seconds, we'll do the 100. How are we all doing? Okay?
Yeah.
We're going to go for it?
Yay!
Yeah. Enthusiasm. Right, okay, so when you're ready, we've got legs in tabletop, all legs extended, nod the chin, curl up, tuck your chin right in as much as you can. So you're trying to make a rounded shape right up through the back of your neck to your head. If your head hangs halfway back, that gives you a neck ache. Tuck it as much as you can, look towards your belly button. Raise your arms. You ready? Off we go. Breathe in. Two, three, four, five. Out. Two, three, four, 10. 20. Lower your legs to work harder. 30, bring them in to work, make it easier. 40, in, 2, 3, 4, 5, out. 4, 50, your lower back into the floor. Then again, look at your belly button. But make sure you pull in a bit more for a little bit. 80. Out, 2, 3, 4, 90 in, 2, 3, 4, 5, out, 2, 3, 4, 100. And that smells done. Well done. Place one foot down on the other and have a full body stretch. And just breathe. Deep breaths, wide and full. Feel the ribs expand as you inhale. Feel them close as you exhale. Okay, bring your arms over. Okay, and just pop yourself up for a second just so I can show you what we're going to do next. Because you'll end up facing a wall at some point. Right, so I'm going to do a side lying leg kick. So I'm laying on the centre line of the mat, but I'm bringing the feet to the front corner. And then I'm going to put a slight bend in the bottom leg. The top leg's going to flex and exhale forward. Point to inhale, come back. Flex forwards, point back. Now you might find it confusing because before lockdown I was doing it a different way. But I've changed it.
Maybe what's happening lockdown.
You know? I've done a whole lot of Pilates course, haven't I? Right. Okay. So that's it. So we can go flex forwards and back. Okay, then we're going to do both legs and we'll do 10 double leg lifts. Okay? So we're going to face that way first. So I'll talk you through it again. Line the centre line of your mat. So I think I should have a line drawn down the middle. And then look down towards the front corner of your mat and bring your toes to there. Lift your top leg up, keep it there, and just put a bit of a bend in the bottom one. And then let your head relax on your arm. If you need to put a block between your head and your arm, you can. Okay, so we want to keep the pelvis really still and stable. Take a breath in to prepare, flex your foot. Exhale, bring it forward to the flexed foot. Now point your toe and bring it back. Exhale forward, point the toe, inhale, bring it back. So keeping the bottom leg really still and pushed down. Go forward and back. Fine, your spine's staying really still. Your pelvis is staying still. So flex forwards, keep it the same height as your hip. Breathe out your mouth. And last one, 10. And hover it on the bottom one and straighten your bottom leg. Okay, bring them both on the centre line on your ankles. Your toes will be near the corner. Bring the feet together. Point the toes. Lift the legs. Exhale, flex your feet. Inhale, bring them down and point. So exhale, lift, flex your feet, inhale down and point. If you can balance, put your hand on the side of your leg. This time, hold them at the top. Okay, raise your top arm up to the ceiling and balance there for 30 seconds. Stay there. So your arms up in the air, your legs are lifted, and balance. Keep holding it, keep breathing. Just take your toes towards the front edge of your mat a bit more, everybody. Just a tiny little bit. Not so they go over the edge, but sort of towards. And you might just find that you'll feel it better on the inside of your pelvis. If they're too far back, we'll be rocking forwards. We're going to feel like right side. Sally, just go forwards a little bit more with your feet. A little bit more. No. take hold of your top foot and stretch your quads. Do a full roll over to the other side. Okay, get comfy. If you're finding it because you're only on a thin mat and not got the purple ones, then towels or something to put underneath your hip. Put that in your kit bag as well.
Carpet?
Yeah, I've got some cut-off bits actually. Okay, so on the centre line, bring your toes to the front edge of the corner. Raise the top leg and then put a slight bend at the bottom one. So that's going to help keep you stable. Just have a little rock forwards on that hip. Okay, take a breath in to prepare. Exhale, flex foot forwards. Point the toe back. Flex foot forwards. Three, keeping that foot the same height as the top of your pelvis. Four, and that's you get the hip flexors working, the abductors, and then the glutes to come back. Keep lengthening through the body at the same time, keeping on the centre line. Bottom leg stays really still and pushes down into the floor. Okay. Round 10. And straighten your bottom leg and bring the top one down to it. Point the toes. Okay, exhale, lift. Flex the feet down and point. Two, you can balance the hand on the side of the leg. Three, flex. Doing well, keep going. Six, again, just watch your feet not swing back. Seven. Eight. Nine. And ten. Hold it at the top, reach up with your top arm. Hold 30 seconds. Head relaxes on the arm. Stretch out. You can point your toes and stretch your fingertips to the back. Keep holding it for another 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one, and relax. Bend your knees and take hold of your top foot. Brilliant. Okay. Push yourself up into shell stretch. Just turn your head around to face this way in shell stretch. Push your bum back towards your heels, arms stretch out in front. Okay, let's come down onto our front now and do some back work. So, you take your feet to the corners of your mat. The edges and your hands are out by the side of the jaw. Forehead's on the center line, your breastbone and the pubic bone. and just rock your hips down the mat. Okay, so we'll start with the original swan. So you start with that little nudge of the imaginary marble with your nose. So you inhale, nudge. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lengthen, you're going to lift a little bit more. And exhale all the way down to the bottom. So we inhale, nudge. Exhale, lift. Inhale. A long breath at the top there and all the way down. As you inhale, you can raise the arms. So we'll start with the inhale, nudge. Exhale, lift. Now inhale, raise your arms. And exhale, lower. If you want to, you can do legs as well. Nudge with the inhale. Exhale, get your height. Inhale, tense up your bum and your trapezius muscles and fly. Skydiving. And all the way down. Inhale, nudge. Exhale, get the height, extension. Inhale, step low. And exhale, all the way down. You can do that without the legs, me too. Nudge. Lift. Squeeze. And release. Nudge. Lift. And squeeze. Let's do a couple more. Inhale, nudge. Exhale. Lift. Inhale. Arms and legs. Exhale. All the way down. One more go. Nudge. Lift. Inhale. Everything. And take it down. Well done. Okay, let's sit back into shell stretch. And then we'll do a few more stretches. So when we did scissors, that stretched our hamstrings. So if we come up and do cat and cow, onto the hands and knees. Again. Let's get the correct position with the hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips, and then start to flex your spine, and then extend the spine. Don't push it too far if you find it's uncomfortable. Just do mild movement. Or you can really go for it if it feels nice. Try and arch as much as you can. You don't need to hollow as much as you can, just a little bit of extension. Last one. Take one leg forwards. We've got the pelvic tilt. So we get that tuck under, so you can feel the stretch in the hip there. You keep this hand on the leg, and the other one comes up and stretch over. Now that arm you've got stretched over, place the palm of the hand between your shoulder blades. Now take your other arm over and get hold of your elbow. And pull it over a little bit more, so you get a tricep stretch. We get lats, we get obliques, QLs, and hip flexor, all at the same time. All of it. And then use your breath and stretch even more, so inhale to that side of the body. And at the centre. Release. Switch. Pelvic tilt. So you feel that stretch. So it works hard every single time we do a leg extension, quite a lot. Those hip flexors are working hard. Good, stretch over. Get to where you need to be with that lateral flexion. Place the palm of the hand on your shoulder blades and then grab your elbow. We'll push it down a bit more and pull it over. And then that to really step up. A little march out there. Okay, so just something that we didn't do in the beginning. Toy soldier. Inhale, exhale, opposite arm and leg. Just to get us back into our posture. Work on your centering, where we need to be. Good posture forever. Good. Let's take it, hold it, out to the side. And down. Just loosening up around the hips again. Good. One more. And down. Let the arms swing around. Rotation, a little bit of a tuck underneath your tailbone when you do this, just so you've got some stability around your pelvis and you're blown back. Okay, roll the shoulders, shake out the arms, bend the knees and lift. And out. Come again. And one more. Put the hands together, down through the middle. Give yourself a great big clap. Thank you very much, everybody. Did you enjoy that? I forgot something. Homework. Plank. Your plank for homework.